الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على أشرف الأنبياء سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. The last time I met Sayyid Abbas rahimahullah was earlier this year, and prior to going to his house there was congestion on the streets of Makkah al-Mukarramah. I found him and he said, why are you late? I said, Sayyid, Makkah laysat kama kanat. Makkah is not the way it was. I was referring to the streets of Makkah al-Mukarramah because they are doing construction in Makkah al-Mukarramah. He replied by saying, Naam sadaqt, Makkah laysat kama kanat. But in his voice there was a sadness. And he was referring to the Makkah al-Mukarramah which he knew as a child. And that city, Makkah al-Mukarramah, was preserved. It was preserved under the Ottomans. And even post-Ottoman rule, Makkah al-Mukarramah, during the childhood of Sayyid Abbas rahimahullah, was a preserved city. And the men who lived in that city at that time were the men who do not live there now. They were men who had met and stayed with the likes of Sayyid Ahmed bin Zaini Dahlan, Sayyid Umar Hamdan, Sayyid Amin al-Kutbi, Al-Arabi al-Tabani, rahimahumullahu jami'an. These are names that many people now do not even know, and do not even know the history of that city and the culture of that city at that time. Sayyid Abbas rahimahullah was that connection, that old connection to those old times. And this is not something that we just romanticize or are nostalgic about. This is a reality that as the days go further, pious people are passing away. The likes of Sheikh Ahmed Habbal rahimullah and the likes of Sayyid Abbas rahimullah.